Welcome to another edition of AM Chat. I am Tomi Siojo, and it's a beautiful Tuesday morning. Today is a beautiful day, and if you look around you, I'm sure that a lot of people are still managing the traffic. You know, my guest just told me about how long it took to navigate just within Alausa. So it really is that bad. And you know, like I usually say, maybe time for you to consider leaving home at least 30 minutes earlier than you used to, you know, ensure that you get to the office as early as possible. My name is Tomi Siojo, and I'm the host for today's show. We'll be talking business today. We'll be looking into the business scene, and we'll be looking at every section of business. Today particularly, we're looking at investment and opportunities in the business sector. We're looking at today in history, November 13. What does November 13 stand for in the history of the world? Right now, the president is in Paris talking about the peace forum. You know, all over the world, today is the day that most people would be thinking. You know, the peace forum just came to an end. If you're wondering what that is all about, is the centenary celebration of the World War One, and that's what it is. November 13, you know, across the world. I'm just trying to look at what exactly November 13 stands for across the world. It's the day you have a lot of things happening today. Maybe somebody's birthday out there. And apart from the fact that it's somebody's birthday, in history, the English king orders the killings of all the Danes in England. That's on November 13, World War II. You know, the aircraft carrier World War II, HMS Ark Royal, was toppled on the 13th of November. Looking at a few ones, I'm just looking at a few ones. There are lots of things that happened today. So today in history, in a referendum, voters in Sweden decided to join the European Union. In 2002, you have the oil spill. A storm bust a tank of oil tanker, which was not allowed to dock, you know, and sank. The tanker sank on the 19th of November. Okay, we have in 2015, a temporary satellite of Earth impacts just southeast of Sri Lanka. That's all on November 13th. And if you're looking at people who were born on November 13th, quite a number of them. Amongst them is Ranjit Singh, that's the Sikh emperor. Among them is a lot of people, quite a number of people. I'm just picking the very popular ones. Robert Stanley was also born, American actor, was also born on this day. And in recent times, we should look at people who are very, very close to us, very, very close to us. We have 1994, Andrew Tang, Singaporean race car driver. Okay, so quite a number of things have happened on November 13, and ultimately it says that every day is important. And so you must make the best of every day. Every day, make sure you do your best, make sure you put in your best, make sure you do all that you can. And if you are at work, it's a day to be productive, work smart, you know, do a quite a number of things. Because today we're looking at business, so we're going to be looking at our general outlook to business, you know. My first guest is in the studio, and we're talking straight about investment opportunities in Nigeria's borrowing. You know, people have been talking about the external debt, internal debt, whatever it is. And I have some statistics here that I'd just like us to look at. Nigeria's debt profile is now at about $73.21 billion. That was what the Debt Management Office, you know, released. It said in 2017 we had to increase by 3%, that's 21.68 trillion naira. That was at December 2017. As at June, the second, the end of the second quarter of 2018.